We are looking at unit number 4, that is Introduction to Boolean Algebra. And in this, we are taking chapter 2, that is the Boolean function and reduced forms. So what we are going to see here is how logic relates to computing problems, how we can handle simple Boolean functions in sum of product and product of sum form. We'll try to apply rules to simplify or expand the Boolean terms or functions. And then we'll use K-map and algebraic method to simplify the Boolean function. And then the Carnot map, the correspondence between K-map, truth table and the logical expressions. So what we have seen is the Boolean functions. Boolean functions, we have binary variable. This can appear in normal form also or complement form also, means A and A dash. Now, if we have two variables, say A and B, and if we have an AND operator between them, means A and B, then this A and B can come in four possible way. What is that? A can come in A, A dash, B can come in B, B dash. So the four combination will be A dash, B dash, A, B dash, A dash, B and A, B. Similarly, if you do OR, means plus. So A, B, A dash, B, A plus B dash, A dash, B dash. So they are certain ways in which this can come. The options are this. So now let us see the AND one first. This is called the min term. So when we say A dot B dash, this is A and B complement with an AND. This kind of representation is known as the min term. We call it as a min term, or we also call it as a standard product term. So min term is obtained by ANDing these terms. Right, it may be the variable may be complemented. So if the corresponding bit of the binary number is 0 and normal, that is non-complemented, if its bits is 1, these terms are designated using M. If you don't understand this, let me tell you with an example. For example, if we have three variable means 2 to the power 3, that is we will have 8 rows. So here we have 8 rows in this truth table. So we have C 0101, B 0011, like this, and A also 0000111. Now the min term would be the AND of the term. So this is 0, so we will write A dash here, A dash. Then dot, this is B, but B is 0, so B dash. C 0, so C dash. Let us take one more, this one. This is A, but it is 0, so we will write A dash. This is B, and it is 1, so we will write B. C is 1, so we will write C. This will be A dash BC. Again, let us take this. This is A is 1, B is 1, C is 1. So ABC. We call this as M0. We call this as M1 till M7. Small m. Please understand small m. Because these are 8 terms. We start with 0. So it will go up to 7. So these are how many terms? For 3 variable, there are 8 min terms. For 4 variable, 2 to the power 4, that is, there will be 16 min terms from M0 to M15. So M0 to M15, we will have how many terms? That is 16. Now similarly, we have all terms also, or we call them as max terms, or we also say that these are standard sum terms. So the max term is obtained by ORing the operator variable using, if it is being complemented, if it is corresponding bit of binary number is 1, and the normal if the bit is 0. So these terms are designated by M. We don't understand, let us understand it by the table. So this is the same table, we are going to write it for the max term. So these are A, B, C, these are, there are 3 variables, so 3 variables means 2 to the power 3, they are going to be 8 rows. You know how to write it, 0, 1, 0, 1, B will be 0, 0, 1, 1, A will be A, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. Now, here we have A, so since we are writing max terms, for 0 we will write A. Again for 0 we will write B, again for 0 we will write C. We call it as capital M0. Let us take this one. Since A is 0, we will write A, but B is 1, so we write B complement. For C, because C is 1, we write C complement. So A complement, B complement, plus, because this is OR, this is max terms. This we will designate as M3. So again we are having M0 to M7, and these are 7 terms, 8 terms, which are called as max terms. Please understand. In min term, if it is 1, we take it directly. If it is 0, we take complement. In max terms, if it is 0, we take it directly. Otherwise, we If it is 1, we are taking the complement. So max term for 4 variables to the power 4, that will be 16. So M, capital M 0 to capital M 15. Now if you want to see max terms and minimum min terms together, this is the table A, B, C. These are the min terms, these are the max terms. As you see that these two are exactly the complement. If I take this one, let us take one of these, A dash, B dash, C dash. Let us complement it. And by Boolean theorem, that is the De Morgan, you know that this is nothing but A plus B plus C. If you are complementing it, you have to complement it. So this is nothing but A complement of complement. This dot will be changed by plus. This will be B complement of complement. Then C again complement of complement and plus. So A plus B plus C. So these two are exactly complement. That is why one time we have taken 1, one time we have taken 0 here. The 0 as the actual one and the 1 as the complement. For n variables, there will be how many terms? 2 to the power n. So let us use this information for algebraic representation of the Boolean function. So we have a function f1. We are using min term. Please understand, in min term we'll do something else, max term will do something else. So for min term, let us take, this is f1. F1 is a function. So for min term, we will take only the one values. Only the one values. These 4 we are going to take. And what are these? This corresponds to A dash, B dash, C plus. Then you will use plus sign. Because this is the sum of product form. We are producting and then we are summing. Then again this one, 1. A, B dash, C dash plus this one. A, B, C dash. Now this one plus A, B, C. So this is the function. F1 will be represented by this. Okay. So F1 will be represented by these 4 terms where we have taken only 1 which is lying in the table below F1 which are giving 1. These are called as sum of product form. See, we are producting, then we are summing. So this is the sum of product form. F1 can be represented as SFP form. Now you can represent it in another way. These two. Let us see what these are. This term is not what? M1. This is M4. This is M6, this is M7. So you can also write in this M1 plus M4 plus M6 plus M7. Because this is sum of product, you can also write sigma. Take this, the subscript 1, 4, 6 and 7. This is what is being done here. M1, M4, M6, M7. So instead of using product terms, we can just mention the min term designation. 1, 4, 6, 7, this is the subscript. So these all, 1, 2, 3, these all are the representation of sum of product form. So let us take one more example. Say, we have to find, say this one, F4. Right? And this is sum of product form you have to find. So you have to just check for 1. All 1s you have to take, 0 you have to just leave. So 1, what is this? X dash, because it is 0, we have to do X dash. This is Y, because this is 0, Z dash. First will be x dash y z dash. We are doing it for f4 only. F2, f3 we have left. Plus. Now second one. This is 0, 1, 1. So this will be x dash. This will be y. This will be z. So x dash y z plus. Now this one. X y z dash. X y z dash. Plus this one. X y z. All are 1. So we will take x y z. So this is the f4. So f4. X, Y, Z is equal to this one. Or you can also write M12 plus M3 plus M6 plus M7. You can also write sigma 2, 3, 6, 7. This is going to give you F4. So this is our F4. I hope you will be able to do for F2 and F3 also. So this is how we represent the algebraic representation of in sum of product form. Now, what if we want to represent the this in the complement form? That is, we want it in the product of some form. What we have to do here is, we just have to change the complements, means we have to complement each variable and change the dot to plus or plus to dot. Right? This is so simple. This sum of product can be changed to product of sum by doing what? Plus by dot, change plus by dot, dot by plus, complement each term. So x complement of complement is x. We are changing this dot to plus, this dot to plus, and y complement of y is y, z complement of z is z. And then this is plus, so we are changing it by dot. So we are just doing these three, and we are getting this form, which is nothing but the product of sum form of f1. Product of sum form. So this is so simple. You just have to complement each variable, dot by plus, plus by dot. Just change it. The sum of product can be changed to product of sum form. So product of sum form, we are dealing with zero, right? So we work on the complements. Product of sum is nothing but ANDing the max terms. ANDing the max terms. So product of sum can be represented like capital M. So m0 dot m2 dot m3 dot m5 like this. F1 can be represented by pi 0 to 3 5. So let us take these two. First try to solve it using these two, using sum of product form and then product of sum form. So sum of product is quite simple. What you have to do here is, one, you take, we are doing sum of product first. Sum of product is what? You have to take the one only, ones only. So sum of product will be, what will this be? X dash, y dash and z. So x dash, y, z, z plus. Now what this will be? This one, x dash, y, z dash. X dash, y, z dash. So this will be your sum of product form. How about product of sum form? You are not going to take one. You are going to take zeros. You are going to take zeros. And you have to take zero as it is. You don't have to complement it. The first one will be x plus y plus z dot. Okay, dot. Then next one is x, and now you have to complement here for product of sum, y dash z dash. So x plus y dash plus z dash, and similarly all these terms. So this will be simple sum of product form, and as I suggested, this was the form of the product of sum form, and you can easily formulate this using the complement of this one, right? If you can complement this, the product of sum form, you can get easily the sum of product form, or you can take zeros. This is 0, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 0, 3, then till 7. And you have to use the pi sign. So conversion from one form to another is quite easy. Just interchange OR with AND, sigma to pi. List those terms which are missing in the original. All those terms which you are missing has to be written. 1, 2. You just see 1, 2. Apart from 1, 2, what will be there? 0, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is how you get the product of sum form. So, this type of expressions, like what we have seen in this, we have product of sum or sum of product form. We call them as canonical terms. So, the product of sum of product form are canonical forms. We have seen this in algebraic form. Now, if you want to represent it to truth table, this is also possible. We have worked on canonical Boolean function. Now, we want SOP, POS, and we also want them to be reduced or simplified form. So, simplified expressions are very effective and efficient because they are easier to understand and less prone to errors. Canonical expressions are simplified or minimized so that we can get a reduced form. Actually, the logic gates or the circuit is designed only when you have the least or simplified version of the Boolean function. So this Boolean function may be reduced in many ways. Two ways are algebraic manipulation and Carnot map. Algebraic reduction is simply by using the axioms and theorems we have. There is no fixed rule. You and me, we are going to solve through algebraic expression. We may arrive at different answers or different minimization. See, let me tell you that if we have an example, AB dash plus AB dash, A plus B dash plus AB dash. What we are going to use is, we are going to use here De Morgan's. A plus B dash is nothing but A dash dot B dash. Here. Now you take B dash common. A dash plus A complement with the same number is going to give you 1 always. So 1 dot b dash is b dash. So this is the simplification. This is how we do the simplification using the axioms and the theorem. Again, if we have ab plus ab dash plus a dash b, take b common here, a common here, a, b plus b dash is 1. Again, here also you can, this a dot 1 plus a dot b, by absorption we know that a plus a dash b is a plus b. So this is the simplified version of this expression. But what I want to tell you here is that if you tell, or somebody says me, oh, I don't understand this absorption, I may not get this. So he will stop here. So this, for him, this will be the minimum one. For me, this is the minimum one. So there is always, when you do it, different person will do using different axioms theorem, you may or may not reach to the simplified version. So this is only up to our understanding of the axioms and theorem. So before I can tell you about the Carnot map, which is going to be taken in the next section, before I go ahead, let me tell you that we can also change the reduced form to the canonical form. Canonical form is what? We ought to have these forms, sum of product or product of some form. We ought to have this. If these two are not there, we cannot call them as canonical form. So if a plus b is there, there is no b here, there is no a here. With this term, there is no a, with this term, there is no b. So this is not canonical form. So what, how to do it? A can be written as a dot 1, b can be written as b dot 1. We want b here. So we'll represent 1 by b plus b dash. We don't have a here. So we'll represent 1 by a plus a dash. When we multiply it, a dot b, a plus b dash. Again, for this also, b a and b a dash. These two will come, and because these two are similar, we'll just write 1. A dot b plus a dot b dash, a dash dot b. So this is the canonical form. So we can also reduce the expression into the simplified form, and we can get the canonical from the reduced form. These are possible. So let us see the Carnot map. Carnot map is nothing more than the truth table. It is just the specialized form of representing so that we can minimize the Boolean expression. Carnot map or K-map is developed by Maurice Carnot at Bell Labs in 1953. The map is specifically used to reduce the Boolean expression quickly and easily. Just by view, you can easily reduce it. So there are four steps. First, you have to draw the K-map. Then you have to fill the K-map using the Boolean expression. And you have to group. This is very important. Grouping the terms. So you can group in the terms in 2, 4, 8 or 16. 2 to the power. Only 2 to the power grouping is possible. Reading the, after that, once you have done, then reading the answer out of it or the reduced form out of it is also very important. So these four we are going to see. First is drawing a K-map. If this is your truth table, how you are going to draw? You just have to see that how many variables are there. 2 variables. 2 to the power 2. So 4 boxes you have to make. 4 boxes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now this is 0, 0. First in this box you make a line. This is A, this is B. This is A dash, this is A. This is B dash, this is B. Now you see the intersection of these two components. So A dash, B dash. A dash, B dash. This will be represented here. A dash B will be represented here. A B dash will be represented here. A B will be represented here. Okay. And this is nothing but M0, M1, M2 and M3. This is M0, M1, M2, M3. Right. Now, if you have more than that, means more than two variables. So, you have three variables. So, there will be eight boxes. Eight boxes you have to make because there are only two here. So, we'll make it A. You can have BC here. A dash A. B dash C dash, B dash C, B C, B C dash. So this will be M0, M1, M2, M3. All these are the intersection because this M1 term is nothing but A dash, B dash C. This M7 is nothing but A, B, C. So M0, M1, M2, M2 is here, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7. This is how you make. And this is a different form. You can make this also. This is not very popular. You use this normally. For four variables. 2 to the power 4, so there will be 16 boxes. So AB will be taken here, CD will be taken here, there will be 16 boxes, 4 rows, 4 columns. And this will be A dash B dash, A dash B, AB, AB dash, this will be C dash D dash, C dash D, CD, CD, CD dash, and we'll write M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7, M8, M9, M10, M11, then M12, M13, M14, M15. Right? You understood this? How we formulated it? Now, the basic question is why we have formulated like this. The basic question is, whenever we go from one cell to another cell, there is only change in one value. See, here M0 to M1 we are going, A dash B dash remains same, C dash C dash remains same, and D is complemented. D dash has come to D. So only one variable has changed. You take any other example. Say, take this. Say this one. M9 to M11. Okay. M9 to M11, A, B dash remains same. Here we have C dash changed to C and D remains same. So only C has changed to C dash. So C dash has changed to C. So every time we go to the adjacent cell, only one variable is going to change. That is how this formation is there. So the cells are marked by the minterms, and the main thing is whenever you go from one cell to another, there is only change in one value. Say, because if you are going to A complement, that is only one. So you are changing, or you are going to eliminate the values from here. That is how you do it. How to fill up the K map? Now you have to fill the K map. We have to fill the K map with respect to SOP or POS. If sum of product form is there, you will fill up the ones where you have expression values. If you take POS, you have to fill 0. So you have to make the combination of ones in SOP. For POS, you have to make the combination of zeros. Let us see with an example. Before that, let us group the minterms. So now we are grouping. So we have to group the adjacent cell. We have certain rules, like, remember, our goal is to minimize or simplify the Boolean expression. For that, we have to maximize the group of the size. So if you have 2, 4, 8, 16 groups, so you have to take first 16, then 8, then 4, and if it is not there, then you have to go to 2. See how it is done. So here this, we have various formation. So this combination is correct, which is the power of 2. But this is 3, and this is not the power of 2. So you are not going to make 3 or 5 combinations. You are going to make only combination of the power of 2. Then cells which are grouped should be adjacent. Means this has to be combined with this, this has to be combined with this. You cannot combine this. These are not adjacent. Adjacent are this only. Not diagonal one. Group should not include any cell containing 0. If you combine this with this, it is okay. If you cannot combine 1 with 0, this is incorrect. Then each group should be as large as possible. See, you have made a combination of this, you have made a combination of this, because this is 4, this is 2. Okay, this is done. But you can also make combination of this. Why to make this combination? Because this is making 4, this is making 4, and we have to always go for the maximum. So 4 and 4, this is going to be good. Groups may overlap. As you see here, the groups are overlapping. This is an overlapping. This area is overlapping. So this you can use. This is incorrect. You have to use this. And groups may wrap around also. See, for this member and this member, again if you check, there is only a change of one variable. Complement. This also you can verify. So how to see this? I am taking this one. Okay. 1, 1. I am taking this one. So this is 4 combination. So you can wrap around also. You can combine this with this. You can combine this with this. You can combine these two with this two. You can combine these two with these two. Okay. So the wrapping around is also possible. You can combine even these two diagonal ones. Here diagonal is possible. So there should be as few groups as possible, and because we want to maximize the size, so that we can reduce the Boolean expression. So now the reading of reduced expression for K map, each group corresponds to one product term in K map. The term is defined by finding the common literals in that group. The variables which change their state, we omit them. The only variables we don't change the state, we take them. So we have what we have to do is find the variable listed on the top or side, means here or here, which are the same for entire group, and we have to ignore those which are changing. So let us see. We have a Boolean expression x dash y z plus x y dash z dash plus x y z plus x y z dash. First we have to represent it. So this is x dash, take x dash, and this is y z, so take y z. So x dash y z, we have to place one here. Then again, x y dash z dash. X, this is x, y dash z dash, so we have to place one here. X y z, so this is x y z, we have to place one here. X y z dash, this is x, y z dash, so we have to place one here. Others we will place zero. Now how to make a combination? The combination best is combine these two and combine these two. Cover everything. If you happen to combine these two, this will be left. So don't do that. As you see here, this is what we have found. If we combine these two, this will be left. So you can't do this. This is the best way. This one and this one. Now let us find out what will be the solution. For these two, x and x dash has changed. We will not take this. Y and z remains the same. So y z will be the first one plus. Now take these two. X has not changed for these two. And these two. Y has changed to y dash and z dash has not changed. Z dash remained the same for these two. So we have x, z dash. This is the solution. This is the solution. Okay. Now let us see one more example. This is 5, 7, 13, 15. So this WX and YZ, you know how to make the Carnot map now. So 5, 7, 13, 15, 5, 7, 13, 15, you have to place 1. You have to combine these 4. The answer would be what? What is not changing here? X is not changing. So you have to write X. What is not changing here? Z is not changing. So XZ will be the answer. XZ of this Boolean solution. XZ. Now let's take an example using the truth table. So if we have here, F. So 1 is here, which is x dash y dash z. So x dash y dash z. X dash y dash z. This one. So you have to place 1 here. Again this one. X y dash z. X y dash z. You have to place 1. Now this one. X y z dash. X y z dash. So you have to place 1. Here 1 also. X y z. So x y z 1. So these 4 are there. How to combine these two and these two? All are being combined. So this is your the answer would be in this case, which is not, what is not changing? X is changing, y dash z is not changing. Plus, in these two case, x is not changing, and in these two, y is not changing. So y dash z plus xy, this is going to be your answer. So we have worked with SOP. Let us see POS. In the product of sum form, you can make like this. A, B, C, if three terms are there. A dash will be there. B plus C will be there. B plus C dash, B dash plus C dash, B dash plus C. If you are not able to do this, just complement what you have seen in product of sum form. And this will be M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7. Similarly, for four variable, you can also make, but now you have to make combination of 0, not 1. In product of sum form, you make combination of 2, 4, 8, 16 and so on with zeros in the similar fashion. So if this is pi and it is given 10, 11, 14, 15, you can make the Carnot map like that. You have to place 0 at 10, 11, 14, 15. So 10, 11, 14, 15 you have placed. You have to make the combination of zeros. And see, when you make the combination of zeros, the answer would be, what is not changing here? What is not changing here? W dash. W is not changing here. What is not changing here? Y is not changing here. Y is not changing here and W is not changing here. So you have to complement them. W dash plus Z dash or Y dash. This will be the answer. Because you have chosen zero. Why we have complemented it? Because you have chosen 0. So W, which is not changing, has to be complemented. Then added to the value here. So if this is the form of sum of product expression, how you are going to do this? You make A, B, C. Now, all these ones you write, but you don't take 1. Only take zeros. Combination of 0. So these 4 and these 2. These 4 and these 2, this 4 is going to give you what? A dash. And what is not changing here? Just see what is not changing. B is not changing and A is changed. So B you write, then you have to do dot. How about these two? A is not changing, and then what is not changing here? C dash is not changing. So you have to add this. Okay. So B dash dot A plus C dash. This is how you get the POS out of SOP. So let's revise what we have done. The Boolean expression can be expressed algebraically from a given root table by forming min term and max terms. Min term is ORing. Min term is nothing but the you have n variable min term, which is a product term with n literals resulting in 1. Max term is n variable max term, is a sum term with n literals giving you 0. This sum of product or SOP expression is logical OR of two or more AND terms. The product of sum is logical AND of two or more OR terms. So if each term in SOP POS forms contains all literals, then it is called as canonical form. To convert from one canonical to another, interchange the symbol and list those numbers missing from the original form. The K-map or Carnot map provides a systematic way of simplifying the Boolean algebra expression. For minimizing a given expression in SOP form, after filling the K-map, look for combination of ones. Combine these ones in such a way that the expression is minimum. For minimizing the expression in POS, first we mark zeros from the truth table. Combine zeros in such a way that the expression is minimum. The sum term and product term. Sum term is a single term or the logical sum of two or more literals. The product term is a single literal or the logical product of two or more literals. So this concludes this chapter. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.